The demands of diversity. The Omaha Public School District is spending millions to teach children English.
Nearly 400 educators are part of the language problem, challenged in a district where children speak nearly 100 languages besides English.
Tonight, our I-Team report on how OPS meets that challenge and why it says the money is well spent.
Raquel Caldwell's kindergarten class starts like any other at Dundee Elementary. But in this classroom, English is a second language to more than half of the 27 students. They speak Spanish, Karen, Karini, Kurundi, Amharic, and Somali. Two speak no English at all, and Caldwell's classroom is far from unique in Omaha Public Schools.
We have approximately 100 different languages right now that we're serving.
ESL coordinator Susan Mayberger says the district has about 6,800 ESL students, more than in recent years. 82% of those students speak Spanish at home, but all teachers teach in English.
Tons of visual signals, lots of peer tutors.
In the classroom, teachers encourage kids to help each other break down the language barriers.
So if we're going to share an idea with the class, I often have them turn and share their idea with a partner.
Kindergartners guide their classmates, sometimes without even knowing it.
They follow and parrot what everyone else is doing in the classroom. So if we all get up and stand and put our hand on the heart for the pledge, they will do the same.
But the interaction and daily lessons can only do so much. That's where ESL teachers come in. The Omaha Public School District employs 146 ESL teachers, 211 ESL paraprofessionals, and 39 Spanish-speaking bilingual liaisons, or interpreters, who help the school communicate with students and their parents.
The liaisons are the bridge between the home and the school, and they're helping our families become connected to our school district, and they're helping the school reach out to parents, keep them involved in their children's education.
Omaha Public Schools spends just over $17.6 million on ESL, nearly 4% of this year's $469 million general fund budget. That's more than taxpayer activist Doug Kagan thinks should be spent. Instead of the ESL program, he advocates teaching children in their native language, then letting them change to English as they get older.
It would decrease the teaching staff, and it would decrease the number of paraprofessionals and other support staff they have, so that it would save the taxpayers money.
OPS says the broad range of languages helps broaden the educational experience for English-speaking students. And Susan Mayberger argues that the ESL program may be an expense that fades with time.
If we do a good job with our ESL students right when they come to our school district, we can help them become fully proficient in English in this first generation, and we won't have issues in the second generation.
OPS says it is mindful of the economic burden of the ESL program, and it applies for federal grants to supplement state assistance. Raquel Caldwell says all of her students are trying to learn English.
Kindergarten, our whole world is language development, so the English language students really fit right into what I'm teaching anyway.
And Caldwell says her students will be able to build on their language skills even after this school year. She'll move with the kids to first grade in what's called looping, and will then go back to teaching kindergarten the following year.